Recently, I made a reaction to Trevor Noah doing comedy about his time in Australia, and he did a really good Australian accent. And someone sent me this is like celebrities doing Australian accents. So this, I don't even know if Trevor Noah will be on this, but I guess it's other celebrities doing the Australian accent. So I thought this would be interesting to see if anybody can do an Australian accent as good as him, or just want to see if anybody what people's Australian accent is like. Let's check it out. You can tell me what you think about these as well. Tell me if you think any are terrible, any are good.
G'day, mate. Here's a gun.
Hey.
How's your Australian accent?
It comes in and out.
That's not terrible.
It's not, no, yeah.
Well, now it is.
Yeah.
That's all right.
See, I thought about it.
Oh, you're in your head too much
I
about
was in
this.
the presence of a great beauty.
Oh, this guy. That's very, very sweet. I don't trust you after this movie.
That's
Who is she, man? She was so quick. That was very funny, man. Straight to call him out as well for that bad Aussie accent. Started off good, pretty terrible after that.
To me.
Buster Moon,
Yeah,
right? And
right.
What he
Did you
wants
say
what
that?
he wants to do is get
Matthew
everyone up.
McConaughey and Reese Witherspoon.
Buster Moon.
Buster Moon,
Yeah,
right? And
right.
what he wants to do is get everyone over to the servo and the arvo, get
For
them
exact,
petrol.
see, we would have had, I would have had been subtitled if I would have done it that
I
way.
am speaking perfect English.
But I love arvo, which means afternoon.
Yeah.
So it's great.
I lost it.
I mean, we never really heard much of his accent there. Can't really tell anything from that. I guess good Australian knowledge. He knows about arvo. That's about it. That's all I can take from that one. Charlize Theron, let's hear if she's got a good
To you,
accent.
by the way. I feel like I got a lot of love, and it was great.
Aww, Aussie love, I love
Aussie
it.
Love.
Aussie, oi, oi, oi. G'day, guys. How's it going? You look
Wait,
exciting.
Let me see that again. Was it Kate Blanchett as well? Did
that? That's great.
She knows.
Aww, Aussie love, I
Aussie
love
love.
It. Aussie, oi, oi, oi. G'day, guys. How's it going? You look high.
I'm excited I get to say good day.
Yes,
Hey.
Non-ironically as well.
Yeah.
Effortlessly in sentences. You know what I had was fairy bread. Yes, that's an Australian delicacy.
Yeah, I
No
had
one
fairy
knows
bread.
what this is.
I didn't understand what was going on. I thought the butter was frosting. It was just butter. It was a thick layer of butter.
Yes.
And the bread is not toasted. Wow. It's like a kid's birthday party food though, right?
Yeah.
Do you eat it as an adult ever?
Shh.
No?
The camera.
Okay. Do you not eat it as an
Of
adult?
course you do.
Of course you do.
But
Fairy
it's thick butter on
It's
bread
thick
with
butter.
hundreds and thousands.
It's thick butter with a lot of sprinkles. It was very interesting, and I'm very glad I tried it.
Yeah, I mean, she didn't do an Australian accent. I guess that's just more Australian knowledge knowing about fairy bread. For me, fairy bread looks good, man. I've still not tried it. I've seen pictures of it, and it looks tasty, even though it's for children. Tell me if you do have that as an adult. But like the way she's going, like. It's such thick butter, like as if it's some magical produce, man.
Hi.
Called from Australia.
Oh my God, my
Hi.
Sister's in Australia.
Where is she right now?
Melbourne.
Oh, and you said it wrong.
Melbourne.
Hold on, we gotta get it on camera that you love Adelaide.
I love Adelaide. My favorite city is Melbourne, though. Melbourne is, that's where it goes.
What about Brisbane?
Oh yeah, that's gotta be third. That's gotta be, because Adelaide is so calm, it's so chill, you know, it's like the escape.
That's the
It's
Australian
more.
version.
Australia.
Hey, Australia's great.
Australia.
You can hear all about it and wanna go there.
Yeah. Yeah. I've been there.
Oh, where?
Oh yeah, I've been there.
Whereabouts?
When I was traveling, when I was 19,
oh,
I
yeah.
went, started in Sydney, went all the way up the East Coast, classic backpacker,
yeah,
to Cairns. And then I went back last year to Melbourne to be with my sister.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah.
More.
Yeah, tell me if you're from Australia, what do you think about the people who go backpacking to Australia? Like in the UK, I think the people that kind of do that backpacking or gap year type thing always get seen as being like the posh people. It's like they go to get this like spiritual enlightenment and stuff like that as well. What do Australians think of these like sort of wealthy British people and people from other countries coming to Australia to do backpacking? I guess I can't really call this video anything to do with Australian accents, maybe like celebrities talking about Australia.
Maude Garrett.
That's me.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi, Maude.
We're in Hawaii.
What did they say in Australia? Did they say?
It's supposed to be g'day, mate.
They didn't really say that, did they?
Don't they?
Do they?
G'day, mate.
When I went to Sydney, but when I went to Sydney, they wasn't saying that much.
That's
Didn't you
great.
Perform in Australia?
I did a big show right there.
Yeah, several.
Yes.
Several.
No big
I
deal.
Go all the time and I
Very
go
big
on
deal.
The project and I sit there with a
amazing hosts, because they have amazing hosts.
Yeah.
Of course, as we can see. I'll tell you all about it later. I'll give you all the ins and outs.
No, I used to live there, so.
But that's, okay.
Did he?
Yeah.
I never knew that.
There you go.
Thank you very much.
You won that one.
Yeah, I went to school there.
Well, you know, in Australia.
It's.
For.
My. From Australia.
All day? This has been going on all day?
Every single time.
Amazing!
G'day.
You love Australia?
I love it.
Why do you love Australia?
I'm Canadian, so there's a thread like there.
The cousins.
For sure, yeah.
Yeah.
Man, I worked there for 8 months in 2010 and just had an absolute blast.
Mm-hmm.
The women are fun and just the good, yep. The just the people, they work hard, play hard like Canadians, man. And just, I mean, obviously, I was there in the summer, learned to surf at Manly Beach.
A Bronco is a.
Yeah, tell me about that as well, because I feel like Canada and Australia are quite similar countries. I feel like more so than Australia and the USA. I feel like Canada is definitely more similar, whether it's like economy, the people just being like friendly and down to earth. Yeah, tell me what you think about that connection. Do you feel like more similar to Canada or Canadians than Americans?
It's actually a team of one of the sports teams in Australia.
Is it what?
The Broncos.
You're from Australia.
Where did you think I was from?
I don't know.
Did you think we were?
No, I knew. I thought you was Australian.
Yeah, but he.
I don't know.
That's okay. Australian.
Nice.
Have you been to Australia? No.
No.
Blue Mountains was stunning. What else did we do? Went up the Gold Coast, and Hugh, obviously working with Hugh is like the, you know, he's everything.
Yeah, he's our hometown hero.
Beyond that, you know, so, and he deserves to be, because he's such a great guy.
Isn't he the best?
He is.
Yeah, I'm so glad you have great things to say.
Yeah.
Finish the chocolate chip cookie.
I just came back from Sydney, actually.
You did too, you did.
Where
the
are you? Where
there.
Are you?
You took interest there.
Yes. Yes, it was. I had a wonderful time. I was smart this time. I went back a few days early. Last time I was there for Iron Man, I showed up just in time to do the press. This time. I went there. Yeah.
Get bad jet lag.
We had a good. Not just the jet lag, but you don't get to look around. You're there. It's beautiful, and I brought my kids, so we had a great time.
What's your favorite part? Really quick.
We were at the Rocks, and so that's nice because you get to walk around there. The Opera House is there. Really good restaurants. So that's, we explored mostly around that area. Great Museum of Contemporary Art.
I'm so happy to hear that.
Yeah. Maud.
Hi,
hello, Maud.
Hi, Oprah. You and Virgo must have had an amazing time talking all
the films. We were talking all Virgo.
Spiels, I think, is Spiels. The, it would be the more correct
name. I was talking to him about how to get Randall. An Australian nickname, and it's the last name, and you do, you condense, and then you add an O or
Wait, what do you, who do you think you're talking to? You,
Bloody Mendo.
Yeah. No, you add a Y or an I or an A or an O. So I would say, or an S, I would go with Spiels. Hey, Spiels, how are you?
Spiels.
Spent the whole of last year on the Gold Coast.
Yeah. Yeah. Been obsessed?
I feel like I've definitely explored it. It's a weird coincidence. I think actually I take my hat off to the Australian government. I think it's to do with the incentives that they have created, which are enormously attractive for big studios who want to now go to Australia, because A, the crews are amazing, and that is worth saying publicly. They're so nice and so highly skilled. And actually, I asked a lot of the people I work with on Kong to come back and work on Thor, because we had such a great time.
Tell me more about that. I never knew that. So did the government make it easier for movie studios to film in Australia? What movies have been shot in Australia, like big budget movies and things like that? That was quite interesting, not just to like, I mean, it had nothing really to do with Australian accents, but I guess it's nice to hear these celebrities talking about Australia. Tell me what you think about them. And yeah, I never knew The Rock lived in Australia. Tell me if you knew that. Tell me what you think about this one. Thanks.